Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. In the last video, we discussed about how we can access a non-static method using method reference. And today, we're gonna talk about how we can access a constructor using method reference. Before, if you are new to my channel, just hit the subscribe button so you can get all the updates. Let's jump in. Okay, so the first thing. So we are going to create a constructor. So why do you need to create a constructor in the first place? You have a class and you want to create an object out of it. So that is the reason you're using constructor. So constructor means you always use a new keyword, right? So first thing, I need to have a sample class where I can create an object for it, right? So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna create a class called user, and I don't have much of information inside my class. Or I'm just gonna have only one variable here. It's a username, okay, and I'm going to use a default constructor. We have a username, right? So I'm gonna create a parameterized constructor. Okay, so we all know the syntax for the constructor, right? It's same as the class name, and here it's going to be string username, and then what we need to do, we need to assign the value whatever the people who are passing to this particular constructor. So that value will be replaced with the above username with the line number 7. Right, so now the first phase is done. Let's move on to the second phase. So where we can use a method reference? It has to be a lambda expression or method reference. In the both scenario, the person who is going to receive that, they should be a functional interface. So in order to access this class, we need to have a functional interface in place. Let's create a functional interface. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna create an interface here. So I can call them as a user interface here. So when you call this interface, it has only one abstract method. That is why it's called as a functional interface, right? Let me add an annotation here, functional interface. There is an error now because it doesn't have any abstract method. So I'm gonna create one. So I'm gonna create a method called get user and passing some input, so string name. And the way how we want this particular method, this needs to return a user object. Okay, so user. So now this is my functional interface, right? So I can use it against the method reference, or you can use along with the method reference, you can use with the lambda expression also. Okay, let me try to show you how you can access this user class using the method reference. So we have a class in place and we have a interface in place. Interface is not a simple interface, it's a functional interface. So who can receive the functional interface? Who can apply to the functional interface? It can be a lambda expression or the method reference. And here we're gonna talk about the method reference. So I just created a main method here. First thing, so this is the class which you are trying to, this is the interface which you are trying to call, right? So let's copy this one and user interface. User interface is equal, and here we're gonna provide the implementation part. So you can access, you can use this method, correct? Because when you use this method, which will return a user. So once you got the user, you can modify the data in it, correct? And the way how we can access, we always go for the class name and we use the two colon operator and the method name. This is how we normally use, and here the class name is user. If it is a static method, we're using class name. Non-static method, we'll use object. Since I'm using a class, direct class here, I'm gonna use the class name as a, this is the username which I'm trying to create object for that, right? So, and the interface which you're trying to call is this, I'm sorry, not the interface, the constructor which you're trying to call is this one, the line number 15 to 17. So now I created my class. So now I need to call a method which will return this user type. So under the user, what I can do is I can use a method called new, because new is a keyword which is gonna create an object for your instance. So Why this particular user interface able to accept this one? Because this implementation will gives you a object of user, because I'm calling the user. So inside the user, I have a constructor. How do we create a constructor using the new keyword? So whenever you create new keyword here, by default, it is going to call the constructor here, right? Now let's receive the data. So now I'm going to create a user here. User is equal. And now I need an object, right? So we can use the user interface to get the get user. So now we have the object in place. And then don't forget to pass your input here, because the one we are going to call is a single input method. So this is a method which you are trying to call. So in order to call this method, you need to have the visibility to access the user interface. Yes, I have an interface here, and using that, I'm going to call this method. This will give you a user. So that is what I'm receiving it here. So now what I'm going to do is, so let's try to print the data. So what I'm going to do is out, and here user, let me name. So the name of the user plus user dot. Either what you can do is you can create the getters and setters, and you can use the get username method. That is also fine, but since it's a simple example, I'm just creating a simple variable, and I can directly I'm just accessing them directly. Okay, so now what we need to do, let me run the code and I'll show you what is the outcome. See, we got the name. So basically we are trying to access a constructor of this particular user, and the way how I can access using class name and using the new keyword, because new keyword is create an object for a class. And why I'm using user interface here, because this user interface which will accepts a user, and the method we are going to call is a get user. Okay, so this get user method will return a user object. That is why this user interface is working. Now in case if it is not returning a user, let's try put void here, and it will end up with an issue, because the user interface doesn't have a method where it can accept a user, because it has only void here. So now let me, okay. So, and the next thing, you might think, how I can access the same object using lambda expression, because we know that method reference is a alternate for lambda expression or shortcut for lambda expression, right? So let me show you how the same thing can be done using normal lambda expression. Right, so let's copy this one, and I'm gonna copy it, and I'm gonna paste it here. And interface one is equal, we always write the implementation, how the open close brackets and the token and the implementation. So what is the input here? So I'm gonna call a get user method which is accept a single input. So I'm gonna pass just a single input. If it is a single input, you don't need the brackets. And then I'm gonna call the new user. You might think, why I'm not providing any return here? Because since it's a single-end implementation, you don't have to provide the return keyword here. So now what I can do the same thing here. So whatever we did here, we should be able to do it even here also. So let's copy it and let's paste it here. And I'm going to create a user one. Now name is going to be Janiel. And I'm going to paste the data here, so I can print the name from the user one object. So let me run this, and you should be able to see the response for both of the implementation. See, John coming from the method reference and Daniel is coming from lambda expression. Okay, so in the next video we'll talk about in a different concept. Thank you.